you alone? You may think so as you walk down that city street, but there are eyes that may be focusing right on you. In the case of Ogden City, it may be the eyes of police.
And if he were to mouse over one of these individual points, it will identify who that person is.
There's a little brain center within Ogden City Police Headquarters that has a very wide scope. A few designated officers are watching what's happening on their city streets in real time.
Do you even know all of the places you go in a day where you're on camera? Every convenience store, most of the retail stores in the malls, we don't have them here, but casinos. Most places you go have surveillance systems in place already.
You are being watched.
You are.
Cameras positioned in strategic places on Ogden streets are feeding images to digital video recorders, or DVRs, in the city's real-time crime center. They are placed on government properties overlooking public areas, some of which have been hotbeds for crime.
We see 20 people in the intersection fighting. You should send a couple more cars down there.
They can see you, and they can see your car. So can specialized cameras placed on the light bar of a patrol car traveling through the community. The cameras capture license plate numbers in fractions of a second, 1,000 license plates per hour. The information is programmed into a computer system that can pinpoint the moves of any licensed car over a specific period of time.
Let's just look at every point where this individual stopped for at least 5 minutes.
Just think of that. If officers pinpoint a suspect in a string of burglaries, they can see where that suspect was when the burglaries occurred.
Maybe the offender left the scene of the crime and went to a brother's house or to some other relative's house.
In the real-time crime center, high tech stretches beyond this. Just follow the dots. Big screen monitors allow officers to see on the map exactly where ex-cons live. That could be a helpful tool for investigators when they overlay a map of recent crime locations. And there's more, thanks to social media. The real-time crime center can pick an address anywhere in the world and follow all tweets emerging from that location. Every tweet in a radius up to 15 miles from that selected spot. Amazing techniques, right? So wouldn't you expect an astronomical price tag? Ogden City has set up this real-time crime center, for the most part, with equipment they already had on hand. Using free software available online, they made the right connections to run a multi-level crime-fighting web.
They're all really cool in and of themselves, but when you bring them all together and use that power collectively, it just blows me away.
Or when you get a search warrant for his property...
I think it's awesome. I think it's really interesting to see how deep they can look into what's going on in the neighborhood.
We built what we felt would service a community our size, a department our size. But if I was a smaller community, maybe I don't need a room. Maybe I just need a couple of computer screens at the shift commander's desk with some of the resources.
We actually solved a burglary at this business using this technology.
I think one of the greatest things about this operation is that they're using assets that they already had that weren't being utilized or that they didn't realize that they had, you know, available for one application of running the city that could be benefited for mining criminal data.
So far, it's working. They've caught a repeat burglar preying on three downtown businesses within a few weeks' time, a car thief who they watched get into a truck and drive away, and a group of people with outstanding warrants. That's just to name a few. But has Big Brother gone too far?
I don't care who that guy is or what he has in his hip pocket, unless he's breaking the law.
Susan Wood for the Utah League of Cities and Towns.